Good evening. It's January 14. Another live coding episode. Doing office development today. At the evening that's also occupied by the .NET conference. But anyway, I'm planning to do some more office development here, and let's just start the show. Welcome back, everybody. Another episode of my live coding series doing office development. And it's the same day, I should say, in the US where they have the .NET conference. And let's go to the live coding screen to see my code. Shout out to Sergey S, who followed me 10 hours ago. I am GMD, Alex C-G-O-M, Alex C-G-O-M. Thanks for the follow, thanks for stepping by. In the meantime, my live share is updating on my screen. Let's see if that can click away. Let's have a quick look at the .NET conference, how they are doing. .NET Conf. There's a focus day today on Blazor. What's now? Let's have a quick look who is doing some presentations right now.
The advantage of using this to compare markup is that your tests will be much more stable.
Sound for now. What they are doing today is doing all kind of presentations. And what's up with the screen? I think they have a connection issue. On January 14, focus on Blazor. All kind of presentations. If you go to the agenda. We are currently at, let me check, 1 o'clock. Almost 1 o'clock Pacific time. So they're now testing Blazor components apparently. And going over to mobile Blazor binding by Elon Lipton coming up. Is that true? UTC 9, that's, yes, that's almost an hour ago. So let's go on with our own things here. Developing Office. Let's start the, going to the data projects. Twitch. Demo add-in. Code. Open the code from last time. I have a snowman in my screen, but in the real world, actually a lot of wind blowing around the house. I should say storm blowing. So I hope we survive. Let's check what the status is. Everything should be checked in, right, or up to date. Let's quickly go to the GitHub page. My other screen, let's pull it in. Go to my repositories. That's the Twitch demo add-in. You want to follow along, then you can clone the project. offsetting React task pane. It's more than that. This is the default. This should be 2020. We're already in a new year. So, that's it. If it's on github.com/AAFVSTAM, that's my my profile, like this. Then you can go to my profile and my repositories, Twitch demo it in. And let's see what's the last going on. Yeah, this one, my profile, let's check the check-in list. All going well. Closing this one, and let's see if we can get this to run, npm start. Last time I tried to put in something like yarn, but that, for some reason, I did not get it to work. One of the prestations, by the way, was on the Blazor prestations, was quite nice. Doing a lot of layout stuff. I need to rewatch it and adopt some of the features there. SCSS was one of the items that I really liked. Word is kicking in, but the node server is still trying to get up and running. I'm not getting the resize option here. Why can't I resize this? Yeah, I can resize the whole window. You need to click away the got it message. Wait for the node server to kick in. Compiled successfully with a lot less errors than we had before. No obsolete title items anymore. But that's okay. Now go into the add-in. Go to the task pane. We now should have the home page and an about page and the watermark. And let's see if we actually get the Word item running in here. That's working. So everything is still working here. Go back to the code. Let's go to the to-do page and see what we still have going on at this time. Clean up code after fixing navigation. React strap. Show what React strap is. Style the loading page when not loading. And that the same presentation on Blazor had this nice spinner option. So I could adopt that, but I will go for that first by rewatching the session. Let's find out if we can do something with the watermark in the UI in Office.js. See if there's an interface for that. Watermark with the O, watermark with the A, watermark Office.js. Add in JS watermark. Learn how to add and remove watermarks from Word. Make sure your question and commands are tagged in Office.js. Yeah, packages. How to add a picture watermark with online image. How to add a picture watermark with online. Insert a watermark in Word. Okay, let's go to the top one. Let's see. Watermark manager. Run the sample add-in. Let's quickly change the the year 2019, copyright to 2020, save, and go to the to-do page, start the watermark item. Now we have to check what's the shortcut for starting. Start here, Alt-S. Alt-S on at the watermark. Let's get starting. Run the sample add-in. Open a solution in Visual Studio and select F5 to run the sample. Add sample YAML metadata. What's in there? Put it in, add in, remove, add or remove watermark. Learn how to insert a watermark. Office add-ins, yeah. Watermark manager, manifest, SharePoint. Okay. Oh, it's created by Juanelo. That's Juan Balmori, I think. Let's see if that's right. Yes, it is. That's the PM of Microsoft, doing a lot of development in the Office.js space. So this is a good thing that we have an example from Juan Balmori right here. We start simple, copywriting, sampling. Nice. Let's see how this is done. Go back to the README page. Repos archive no longer actively maintained. Security vulnerability exists. Always disclaimer. Do not use this project as a starting project. Always start production code by using Office SharePoint development workload, Visual Studio or Yeoman generator. That's what we use for our tool. Word editing will show you how to insert a watermark with the text you need and remove the watermark. That's exactly what I want. So go to the watermark page and put a button in there with the home page. We have a run button in here. Let's copy the run button. Copy and bring that over to the watermark page. Bring in the button, and then we need to insert this one, UI fabric button type. Copy. Bring it over to the watermark page. Now we have a button, a class name welcome action, and we have a click event, and the click we can copy from here. I think this was the last bracket. Let's follow the line in here. Oh, we should also put this one in. Click, copy, bring it over to inside the React component. Like this, I think. Yeah. We don't use the get host info. we don't insert a paragraph in here. And no color. Color is not set. Insert paragraph. No. We currently completely strip this. Insert your word code here. Now let's go to the other one. Manage your web. So let's clone this. Clone, let's copy this one. And open VisStudio. Let's see if it's still working, and otherwise we can extract it. Open project a solution, a local project, code from online repository like GitHub, something like this. Repost word and in. Let's move this to see data. See data projects. VisStudio. Word and in watermark. Clone. Let's do it. See how this works. It's opening. Local Git repository. Populate sample data. Wonder what that is. This is the new one. There you are. Now, let's see. Click on switch views above to change between the available views. Which one is more likely to be used? Loading solution projects. I think that's more like it. The properties I want to have somewhere under this. Where's my scroller? My resizing is not working at all. Never. No. A few properties. Where are properties? Properties. Property window. Let's float this. My machine is terribly slow, I think. What's going on? Dock. Move that to the side. Yeah. Oh, that's too much. To this one. Oh, wait. Over there. Now let's see how we can get this in here. But I don't get a resizer here. Not sure why. Is there no option to put it on this side with a resizer on it? Now it's a lot smaller. Not sure why my splitter window is not working. Let's go. And this is the website. This is the manifest. XML. Let's see what's in the manifest. Yeah. And now if we can see to get it running, if we hit F5, rebuilding the Watermark Manager web. Is this the watermark or is my own? This is my own watermark. Windows. This is my own. This should be the watermark part. What? This one. There's no watermark in there. Let's close both word instances. And also kill node. This can go. This one can go. Don't save. It's completely locked up for some reason. While it's updating, let's wait and see what's in the scripts in here. Fabric UI, message banner. What's in the message banner? Target container for instance of message banner. Prototype on resize. It's not in a break, is it? Right now. I think this is hanging. Break all. Let's see. Even that's not working. Using TypeScript 3.7, okay. Close window. Not sure what it's doing. Starting two projects. One should be deployment of the web. Functions, file, initialize. Body is empty since it's evoked using the button. I think this is fairly outdated content. CSS for UI fabric. Home.html, let's see what's in there. button, footer, message banner. One for using displaying notifications. Grid. Button. Oh, there you have the buttons. Let's have a look at this. Type span. So let's have a look at this styling. Watermark page, there's the button over here. Welcome action. Let's make that something like this. The button primary. Copy. And put it in here. Icon. Button icon, inside the button, copy, and that should be class name because we are running in React, class name. Should be class name, and it's all using UI Fabric, and we have that incorporated if I'm correct. And this should not be run, but this should be button text. This create watermark, also class name to comply with React. Description, we don't have a description. We put an ID on this as well, button class ID equals to create watermark. Click handlers do nothing in this case yet. Let's find out if this is working by doing npm start. Nothing is resizing. I'm not sure why nothing is resizing. TypeScript and React, yes, you're right, Dragon. Dragon, please. Yeah, you're right. What we're doing, we're building Office.js add-ins like this, and we have to wait for Node to kick in, and it kicked already in. If you have this add-in, there are now three buttons on here, one menu and two separate buttons, and underneath the button, there's a task pane. And this is actually built in Office.js, React, and TypeScript. Now looking at putting in a watermark. And this is still a dummy button. And I found this project from Juan Balmori. It is one of the PMs from Microsoft. That's adding an add-in. And what I'm doing in this live streams with Office DIS is seeing if it's possible to do all the functions that I'm used to do with .NET VisStudio Tools for Office. That's a FAT .NET client. And this one is XPLAT. It's multi-platform. You can run it in on the Mac, on the web, and also on the Windows, and even I believe on Linux, but that's, I think that's fairly limited at this time. I've been doing a lot of development on VisStudio Tools for Office, and that's all .NET C# type coding, so this is fairly new to me, and a lot to learn there. So if I copy this one, bring in another button, that should be the remove watermark. Yeah, edit the second. Paste. This should be the delete watermark. Seems like this is a change of pace. It is, yes. Developing VisStudio Tools for Office add-ins is, in my opinion, you can do it much faster than doing it this way. But the other one is no longer supported. Well, it is supported, but it's no longer maintained. So it's in maintenance mode. And if you ask the team to do some updates on that level, then there's no update at all. All the updates are on the Office DIS part. Let's see, this is the delete watermark. And the ID, need to change the ID over. I already changed the ID over. Let's save it. Now we should have an, if this one is completed compiling, yes. Now we should see Word, a second button. As you can see, automatically updated. Now we need to find the code how to actually bring in a watermark. Let's see where the event is for this button. Show you how you create and remove a watermark. Input class. That's the text that you want to put in. Enter the watermark. Watermark you need. Let's for fun. Also copy this one. Let's just be a complete copycat today. Save, and now we have to change it over to React again. I'm just learning React. It's quite fun, pretty easy to use. Yes, that's what I like from React. It's quickly learn this. When I started learning this was all done with classes, but slowly now moving into functions with hooks and stuff. But that's also for me it's new stuff, so feel free to hang around and join in. Once you get past the barrier of entry of intricacies like state management. Yeah, and state management, especially if you use classes, is completely different when you use it in functions and hooks. So you have to learn it again, change how to do it when you just use functions. More class names. There's another one. is this? I'm missing a div somewhere. Closing tag for input. Input. Type ID, type. I think he missed the end of the input. I think he missed the end label of the input. Let's see, in the span, the end span, div, that's one matching this one, I think, yeah. Something like this, I think. Text watermark. I'm still new to React Hooks. I'm changing up my code base right now to use Hooks, and it's a pain in the rear. I agree. Completely change of mind. To get around that, I just I took out the state, and that saved me from a lot of the hook stuff. For now, but in the end, I probably will need to bring it in again. I think that was that fixed it. Now save it to prettify it. Yes, it does. Class name. Let's see how this is going over to Word. Compiled successfully. Now we have this. Oh, awful. See, my resizer is also not working. This none of the windows are actually using my resizer anymore. Something with my mouse driver, I think. So put something. The sample shows how you to create and remove watermark word. So let's put some breaks after the input. Where's the input? Here. Let's add a break in there. Compiling. There you go. Compiled successfully. Yeah, that's a little bit better. Oh, it should be somewhat higher, and then put a break after that. So let's move this down. Try again. Save. Compiling. Right. What? Oh, I need another break. I need a break. Not really. A break in my code. They told me that you don't need this the end terminator for break, but then if you do that, my code is actually breaking. How's that for a break? Save. Wait to compile. There you go. Word. A little bit better. Test that will be adopted when I click this one is what I guess. So try to find out. Is this Visual Studio? Yes. Find out what is going on. Format this. Oh, wait. It's an HTML thingy. Where's the handler for the button? Guess I'm better off alone. Never know when I There's no handler for the button. Where's the handler for the button? Oh, it's probably attached to the ID, maybe. Let's find this one. See, my resizer also doesn't work in Visstudio. Terrible. Let's put in the JavaScript in here. Insert watermark. Okay. If not using fallback logic. Okay. Initialize Fabric UI notification mechanism and hide it. Hide banner. Confidential. Yeah, that's the text they put in. Sneaky. So we have to find this one in the code. Function insert watermark. And what if I can just copy this? We're starting the function in here. Follow the line all the way down over here. Copy. Bring that over to here. Copy the function, then because the function is insert watermarks not used at this time, right? But to change that, we can do this, copy, and change this over. Instead of doing this, we are now doing this, insert watermark. Why is this? Right. That should be it. Function context. Get header primary. I think it assumes an existing header, primary, get header. This is a Word Office function. And the value can be primary, so it's no longer valid. This should be primary. Is that backend? I'm not really sure how the Office API works. So, no, it's on the client. It's not server based. It's on the client. Primary should be this one. Probably, I will explain it in a minute. It's probably insert open XML. This should be a replace with a capital R. This is the nice thing of strong typing. This is the function, the other function. The idea is that you just create a website. And you host it somewhere. In this case, I'm running it locally on my port 5000. One or something like that, and then you hook it up to the client into the Word host, and there's a manifest in here that specifies where to find it. So what you tell to Word, what you give in, this is the one that you present to Word. Word only looking at this, and this specifies that in this case the web is running at localhost 3000. And the entry point is something like a task pane. So it's coming in a task pane in this case. And task pane is going deeper in, presenting the app item. Manifest XML. Manifest XML is basically the configuration file for Word to recognize where to get this information. If you go to the options account, no, it's not the right one. Let's go back. File. I think it's options. Yeah, options. You go to Trust Center. Trust Center settings. They have a trusted add-in catalog. In this case, there is this Twitch demo add-in. Share. If I go to this share. Live coding VS 19 Twitch demo add-in. Let's see. Yeah, that's basically, this is a mapped drive, mapped network share to my local drive. And what you see here is basically the same thing that you see over here. See data projects, Twitch demo add-in, and if you go in here and look what's in here, that's exactly the same thing as you look over here, and there's a manifest in here. If you go to the manifest, open that in, select it first, open that in Notepad, for instance, that's actually the one showing in my code over here, this one. So Word knows where to find all the items, and this manifest file also contains all the information on what should be on the ribbon, for instance. There's a lot of handling about security. The website must be secure, so you must have a certificate in place, and it must be you can only access it in HTTPS, and if that's not done, then you can't use it. And because this is a web interface, this actually hooks on the local Word installation. That is, if you use the desktop version for Word. If you use the web version for Word, then it hooks up to the web version running in the browser. So that's kind of complex. I noticed, by the way, that this arrow should be the other way around, if you ask me. So you should change that as well. I'm planning on creating a YouTube movie explaining what Office add-ins are. If you go to, I don't have enough followers yet to get a nice URL. If you look up and go to Maarten van Stam, then there's my channel. I'm planning on all my streams, and this is what I'm currently streaming right now. All my streams are archived on YouTube, and I'm planning to put in some tutorial videos as well, showing what exactly Office add-ins are and how to build them, so you don't have to watch all these 2-3 hour streams and just go over the tutorial for the movie. So let's go back to the code, because we have some issues in here. This function is still not copied yet. Well, it's not. This is a function. Where's my VisStudio? In here, I noticed this one. Copycat. Bring this in here. a piece of XML. He's using the OpenXML technology to put in something in the back of the document, apparently, and bring it in. Why is there a dot 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 at the end? It's not going further. Wow, the line is so long that it's unable to show. Something's wrong over here. This is jQuery, right? This is taking the value of the text button. So for now, let's put in some fixed text. Fixed watermark. And what's going on with my this one? Same thing, the property is not right, should be hidden with the capital, now it's fixed. And show notification, we don't have a notification in here, so did we put in some logging in here? I don't think so. And there's something else going wrong. What run? This is going to something like this one, probably. That's this one. Then we have this one. Yeah, that's matching that one. And if not, then it's presenting something else. Something went wrong. Typing is not my strongest today. And the event is not used. Should not be an issue. Replace confidential with text, but there is no confidential yet. There is some confidential in here. I noticed somewhere. Let's find out. Confidential. That's the changed value. Oh, this is original. Yeah, it's using jQuery to put the value of the text watermark somewhere. And that's somewhere over here. The text watermark, is that in here? That's this one. So, probably what's my watermark? My watermark is a lot of text in here. I'm unable to select it for some reason. Come a little closer. Why am I unable to select this one? Click on this one. No. Copy. Notepad. This is a complete package, is that right? It's probably not, because this one is starting with this. I think. This one is escaped, this one is escaped. So it should end with a... Okay, yeah, it is, because that's a semicolon on the end. So this is what is pushed in. There's a lot of information. And what is replacing confidential in this string? So if I find confidential in here. Right. So what Juan Balmori did in here, where's the Visual Studio project? He created a Word document and put in a watermark. Insert watermark. Where's the watermark? Let's find watermark. Watermark here. I put in, for instance, confidential like this. Then saved it as a different document. Browse. See temp. Disable my caps lock. Watermark. Watermark document. Then we go to Explorer. Go to the temp folder. Now we have a document over here. If you put a zip extension on this, then you get... Oh, it's opening Word. Let's close Word for this. Oh, there we go. In the meantime, also close Note. So we have to restart it. Try again. Now it's a zip document. If we now look into this, there should be something in here that has a watermark. Confidential. Let's see if we can find it in the content. No, and it's, this is one of the bad things in Explorer. It's not finding content in XML files, so we have to find and guess where it is. That's probably in the document. So if we take this one out, I put it on, put it on the desktop. Oh, where did it go? XML. Document XML. This is the one, I think. Why does it have a date there? Open with Notepad. This is the complete Word document. Is there a watermark in here? Confidential. No. So it's still a wild guess. Oh, I was wondering why it was not showing, but it's because I didn't have the icons on. There you are. It was probably this one. Back to Word, zip. Now I lost my mouse. There is my mouse. Don't save. How to find the watermark in here? This is also not resizing. I'm not sure what's going on here. Properties, not too much information. Open with Notepad. Themes. Let's Google it, where is sort, Google. Oh. Where is watermark stored in Word, zip? You show me the things that are just out of sight from my eyes. You whisper the words that will make no hints. Watermark on template, 7-zip. That's not helping either. Well, anyway, somewhere in here, there's a part of it showing the watermark. I was expecting to be in here, although this one is bigger. Open with Notepad. No, can't find it right now. But anyway, let's close this and kill this and delete that and delete this. Yes, and restart this one. See if it's actually working. This one, version, application program, this Word document, part package. Oh, it's putting in the relations, a content type, open XML format. Yeah. I believe that's true. Now let's find out if we can hook this up. Still, this one may be in here. Yes. No, that's not right. Insert watermark is not right. Unless we take this out. Still in scope. Replace. My watermark. Well, you can be replace, start or end. Inserts open XML at a specific location. Oh, it's replacing the complete open XML. Let's see how this is running. 5. No, I don't want F5. I want npm start. No, it's starting anyway. Let's see if this actually runs the way I expected. Oh, it's not starting my word as well, so let's close this. Let's do it the other way around. NPM start. It's much better, I think. Now, word is kicked in. Yeah, we have to wait for node to finish. Boom, boom, boom. You can do it. Ah, there it is. Go to Word. Got it. Live coding task pane. Now we have a watermark. Thingy in here, create watermark. It did do something, but I think we had an error here. Because I don't see any watermark in here. Mark. I know where it is, but I don't want to know where it is. Where did they put it? Word art. Where's the watermark part? Design maybe? Layout? Station. What name? Mark. Where did they put the watermark? Watermark. How we can find it here? Maybe. Oh. And options. Customize ribbon. No, don't restore the pages. Insert watermark word 2016. Design type. Page background group watermark. Design tab. There it is. Right. Now I need to know why this is not working. Can we put a break in my code? F9. Can we create watermark? No. Let's reload the item. Because I think something went wrong. If I create watermark, something is going on here. And now it's not working anymore, I think. It is. It's flashing. Oh, wait. There is some watermark in here. Fixed watermark. It said fixed watermark. And... oh, really? Yes. It actually did it. So how to make this more dark? Oh, it's on your streaming screen. It's much better. You see it much better than this. Oh, I tried to show it to you, but twitch.tv. There's Maarten van Stam. Let's make sure that the audio is not on. Yes. Should be able to see the window in here. Yes, the watermark is much better at your side when you're watching this. So it actually worked. So now let's do the other way around by removing the watermark. Let's try the function. Let's go follow the lines. Copy. Go into the code again. And then we have something like this. Oh. Tap. Delete this one. What? Why is there a double catch in there? Catch. Need to fix that later on. That's that level. Then this is that level, I think. Another catch. Something is missing. Let's check this. That's the bracket matching this one. That should be at this level. Oh, wait. If I save it, yeah, it's formatting. My prettifier is saving me. Get header primary, that should be the head. Capital, get by title, content control. Do we have a content control in there? And item delete. Why is that not okay? Delete the content control and its content is keep. An argument for keep content control is not provided. Is that forced then? Keep content, okay. False. By default, what's the default? If keep content is set true, the content is not deleted. what should be the default previously. Required indicates whether the content control should be deleted. If content control is set to true, let's see what the default is in .NET, Google. Content control. What I can do is go into Visual Basic by going into Developer tab, Visual Basic, press F2, and then content control. And there should be a delete somewhere. Here. And delete content control as boolean is false. So if you leave it out, then it should be false. So by default, this should be false as well. Keep content. How is this done in JavaScript? Named params, parameters, JavaScript. Okay. So this is the same like false. Something like this. No, that's not right. Out a name, then it should work. That works. So what this does is it takes these sections, then SOC document save, load my sections from the document, then get header primary, the first header. Oh, it's probably attached to the first header. Get my temp CC, temp content control. Is there a temp control? Yes, that's in here as well. Oh, really? So we can look at this. We go to Word, close Visual Basic. We have this watermark still in, if I'm correct. Yes. So if you go to the header in here, there should now be something like content control, if you ask me. That's this one. So if you edit this, this is probably content control. This is a content control, developer, design mode. A bit hard to see, but apparently properties, no. Looks like there's content control in here called temp, my temp CC. We can go in Visual Basic and create a little function, sub count content controls, content controls, message box, active document, content controls, count. Five, zero, but it's not the content, it's on the headers. Section. Sections, first, headers, item, I think it's zero, content controls. Five, no. Stop this. Oh. Items. Item, this is the one, then I think it's zero based. Range, content controls, yeah, count. Maybe a one, it's one based. Yes, it's one based. Now the question is, item, null, name, content, text, no, title, does not exist. Oh, it's also one based maybe. My temp CC. Yes. And what's the second one? We have two. Do we have two? Okay, I just put in two. Okay. Right. So for that reason, let's stop this Word document, don't save. So we actually have two content controls in there. So we need to test if the watermark already exists. What? Stop it. Let's make that a to-do item. Oh, where's the to-do item? Enter, test if created, if watermark already exists, watermark already exists, if so, delete and create new one. Is watermark an option? So that's a yes. That's a yes. What's the way to archive this? Control Shift A. Control Shift A. Just a pro duck. High level language are pretty shit. It is, yes. Low level language depends on what's the way you look at it. Top down or bottom up. Assembly is even worse if you ask me. Control Shift A. I thought this should be archiving. Control Shift A. Yeah. So let's start this again. Oh, this is the wrong project. Where is my, this one? Go to the watermark page. And then we have this thing, it's not running. Ah, it also wrapped this nice item over here. This is a complete watermark. There's a text in there. Wow. That's taking a lot of code in here. Yeah. Should take that XML part out, I think. Read it from file. Remove. It's not used yet. That's true because I don't have a thing on the click in here. The click should be click create. Is it create? Yes, create. Then the other one is click remove. The icon dash dash plus. Is there also one going the other way around? UI fabric icons. Search. Where's the arrow? Here, this one. Chevron right. Okay, chevron right. So it's not a plus. It's this one. Delete should be chevron left, I think. Just to differentiate a little bit. Click remove. We need to change the click handler. Now we have this huge amount of code in here. Extract the open XML part to separate file. Insert watermark. There's the click, and then we click insert, I think. Was it click insert? Darn it. Bad memory. Click create. Okay. Click create. Also nice. Click create. No. What? Yeah, it is. Watermark page. It's part of the watermark page. Copy. Then we have to click remove, delete. No. Remove. Yeah. And that should be remove VM, I think. Insert watermark. All the way down. So the other one is called insert watermark. Remove watermark. Let's make this watermark. Come on, my typing is really bad today. Nice. So let's do this. NPM start. Got it. Wait for note. What's it complaining about? Yeah, the event for the catch is not defined. Try this. Watermark. Now we have the returned watermark. Create watermark. Now there is no watermark if I look at this. Create watermark. Now you should be able to see something like a watermark in here. Yes, there's a watermark. Now delete watermark. That's a challenge. There you go. Delete is a lot easier because what I know is that but this is kind of cheating. Because in this case, you know that there's content control in there. So I don't think this is the nicest solution. Because you want to know actually if there's an existing document. Because if you have a clean document, that usually you're not aware of where the watermark is residing. And in this case, you just collect content control typed by my temp CC, but an independent document created by someone else containing a watermark, you never know where this is stored. So this is a little bit much. This table, colorful. So I wonder what happens if you change the color of this thing. Create watermark. Now you have a new one. Click on this. Now you see the watermark in here. If I select this, um, Okay, create something, the text, like make that red, for instance. You can. Now it's red. No, it's not what I wanted. Apparently the opacity of this item is also different. No gradient, more colors, custom. It's nothing about a gradient. Let's see if we can change the color of this. Cancel. Not sure why the this is pretty much text effects, maybe. So transparency, that's this one. Oop. Okay. Oh, really? Come on. Oh, I messed things up now. Put a transparency on 100%, that's not right. Stupid. It should be 0, obviously. Okay. There it is. Now if I click outside. That's more readable right now. And now delete this. Hi, Alex Seagum. Thanks for the follow. Last 4 days ago. How are you doing? I'm almost closing up. What I accomplished was that I was able to create a watermark and now delete it again and create it. And now you can see it, but it's a little bit transparent. Need to fix the transparency of this. Your print preview, let's see what the print preview looks like. Okay, there you go, fixed watermark. Remove it. I think we have a working watermark. Capelgen. Is that working? Oh, it misspelled, I think. Google. I'm studying for the last exam in university tomorrow. Wow, then you're all done. Set and done. Capagin. Stream elements. Capagin, it's not working anymore. Why is it not working? Capagin. Strange. That's not working. Capagin. Let me check the commands. Bot commands, jet commands. Default. Moderator Capagin, should work. Why is it not working? strange. Oh, I removed the Capagen from the screen, I think. Yeah. I think it's on one of the other screens. Let me quickly check. That's not on this one. What's the main screen that we are working on right now? That's this one. Should work. Capagen. Why is it not working? Well, good luck with your exam tomorrow. Capagen. Capagen. That's what was I was typing, didn't I? Nothing's happening. Stream elements thing is not working. That's strange. Okay. My Capagen window is failing. This is the Capagen screen window. Change. Let's see if that's working. Copy. Oh. It's a snowman? Really? Capagen. It's not working for some reason. Let's change it over to a different overlay. Oh, really? Wait. Let's check this. Go into my overlays. And have a look at the Capagen thingy. Launch the overlay. And send the Capagen. Oh. Bang, Capagen. Oh, really? It's not active in my view today. Wow, that's bad. Why is not in here? Darn it. Well, I've replaced it with the holiday theme, I think. That's sad. Activity feed. Go back. Back to the code. Close the icons and we can close the params. Google can go. And what in we have no watermark at this time, I think. Create one more watermark. Now we have a watermark. Delete the watermark. It's actually working. So it's ta-da. What's your time zone that you're in, Alex C-G-O-M, C-G-O-M? Let's close this. I think we had nice accomplishments today. Strange that my resizer is not working, my splitter is not working anywhere. Go to GitHub. Let's close some obsolete items in here. Close this one. And we can close Visual Studio. also have to find out what this message banner is doing. Close. Save. Don't save. Don't want to save the code from Juan Balmori. Desktop. Can we close? Now let's also remove the icons over here. Don't show the icons. It's much cleaner. Now check this in. Git status. Let's see where we are. We have modified the README. To do. Oh, that's right. And we have changed the watermark page. That's right. So git add. Yeah. Git commit. Dash M. What did we do? Created. Add watermark. Add and delete. And delete watermark. Feature. We need to make it more generic. Because we now using a specific content control and we don't want that. Commit with the comment, yes. Created, three files changed. Git push. Solving deltas, master to master. Right, git status, and we are clean. Okay, cool. Okay, that's it for today. Thanks for watching on .NET Conf Focus Day. We did not focus on Blazor, but we did focus on Office.js. That's kind of different. That's JavaScript. It's no C Sharp or .NET language at all. But it's nice to look at, and I think we had some real progress today showing how to put in a watermark in a Word document using Office.js, React, and UI Fabric for the layout and stuff like that. So thanks for watching, and I will be back on Thursday. Depending on the time, if we have an SDN cast with the SDN cast team. Otherwise, I may start a little bit early. If you like to know when I'm streaming again, hit the follow button somewhere upstairs in this screen somewhere. You can also just look at the schedule that's down in this window of Twitch. Anyway, thanks for stepping by. Thanks for watching. Alex, good luck with your exam. And maybe see you next time when we are streaming again. See you the next time. Bye-bye.